It just takes a wee bit of practice just to keep playing it, and also a few wee hacks as well. Because you know, for instance, in case anybody doesn't know about that, this one's actually going to be worse than the last one, to be honest. So if I can get to about 100 minutes, it does take a bit of a time, because it's already been about 15 minutes or so that I've been playing this, so I don't want to keep up taking too much of the time. But I will just try and magnet helps an awful lot, because you don't need to sort of be head on hitting everything. Okay, it's a wee bit better anyway. Earlier on, it does damage you collecting points early on-ish. If you hit, if you sort of do what I did and sort of get hit on the wing or whatever it is, it does damage your points a bit. But by the time you're, you know, unleashing 20 or 30 or things like that, it doesn't make much of a difference. Because you obviously are going to hit something pretty much continuously, on your way up to getting high multipliers and higher regions and things like that. I'm gonna try and keep the swearing down to a minimum, because as I say, I do get very, very frustrated playing this game. Especially whenever nonsense like that happens and you don't get a turbo at the end of a level. The far right one there, the one to the right of the one I've just been in, is one I very, very rarely go down. Basically, you have to try and dodge out of the way of those things, and then at the very end, you have to jump. Not jump, it's a sliding door lifts up. And it's extremely tricky. Missed that shit. It's extremely tricky to try and navigate your way through. Even though these ones can be quite difficult as well, especially with this screen and everything shaking and really sort of starting to annoy you. I can't believe I've lost the shield. I've got a shield and I lost it quickly. God damn it. Thank you. do that actually. I didn't want to lose all the jumps because, as I say, they are actually handy to have to get out of the bind. The far right one on these things here with the traps coming down on you, the far right one gives you the most points. So the third one is obviously the middle, and the one on the far left doesn't give you any points at all. It actually has the asteroid level portal, mostly at the end of it. As per usual, you sort of tend to struggle whenever you're like more than one thing. That's what I get for not having any jumps, because I could have got two or three of those things. But it's not really. It's very, very weird sort of just talking over this, because I normally have Spotify on, just with a complete random mixture of music on in the background, sort of. Bit of a laugh. And of course, yeah, I didn't even get the jump. So say this is going to be even worse than what I've just done. So yeah, great fun. Right, definitely getting the jump here. Good stuff. The more that you play it, the more you sort of get used to the patterns and things like that. You know, you sort of have an idea going, oh well, if this bit's here, then oh yeah, I can jump, and you know, I can tend to make it over there, and things like that. But as I say, whenever you're looking for, well, I'm looking for two things now rather than just the one. Just the other sheet. Too busy looking to see where I was landing rather than it's a bit of luck going through that tunnel. Yeah, normally on the far right hand when you're traps hitting or trying to hit you and going down like that, more often than not, a turbo tends to be at the end of it. So I go through those quite a lot. That's why I jump up over them, because I can still grab the points at the end with the magnet and also the turbo. So that's what I tend to do. You can sort of see me always going head round to the right. It doesn't always work with the turbo, but at least you're getting points. Sometimes I do it, sometimes I don't, because say I like to keep sort of two jumps on the go anyway, just to be on the safe side. I would love to grab a few little turbos and a shield, actually. so. As I say, the jumps spawn quite easily. So they do. It's just trying to get in front of the turbos and the shields, of which I've missed another one there. Climate bar. Yeah, I don't understand where that thing is about the mountain actually firing missiles at you, but that in itself, especially in the higher levels, is it's absolutely terrible. Never getting that turbo anyway, it's just there was no way. I'd already turned too far to. Shield rather than the other way around, because the shield is obviously going to heal. I'm literally raging right now. The shields give you an extra chance at things, so make that. Thank you. Again, that's that sort of asteroid level thing. Yeah, so I was just gonna say that every time you sort of you wing, you don't sort of hit it full on. Your wing clips it as such, and you don't actually lose your life or whatever. You lose 5 levels. I think I lost about 15 levels there. Such as things go. Yeah, this is absolutely terrible because I'm not gonna have the sun up for very long, of course. The only thing is, I've got a third. Oh, maybe not, maybe not, maybe not. So, yes, what happens? You're too busy looking for everything, and then you always hit something. Get a turbo here. I think I'm done. Well, I know I'm done if I don't get a turbo here. Yeah, I'm done. Oh, God damn it! Yeah, we'll just say. Well, I'll just show you what happens. Whenever you run out of sun, but you have your portals left or your shield left, this is what happens. It's just you go through them all, and that's it. I'll give it one more go, and then I think I'll try it later on because at this point I'm sort of angry, to say the very least. It's very, very rare for me to hit sort of a high enough level and high enough points for the sort of first time.